It reminds me of what Mick Maloney once said to me when I first started writing about Irish Listening Music. He said, there are no experts in Irish Listening Music. You can always learn more. Yeah, I've taken that apart. I don't think Joe has to. Joe, you mentioned the Dublin Street dance hall scene. And we have a lot of people here tonight, apparently, who remember you when you were 2 or 3 years of age, back there, or whatever. I got it correctly. But they remember you from those years. For those of us who weren't there, describe a little bit about what that scene was. And if you have any amusing anecdotes about playing, say, 3 or 4 dance halls in a given night with a certain company that went to Europe.
I started at the Dudley Street Dance Hall with the John Powell Band. It would be around 1946, 1947. And I was in that environment to just about 1960, just before, right in there. I wouldn't be able to give you an exact date. Now, this is a fantastic time in my life and in the life of Austin. I don't think we'll ever see it like again. You have to remember now that World War II was going on, and it wasn't over until 1945. But all those war years, loads of people in Ireland wanted to come out, and they couldn't. They weren't coming out by plane, they had to go by boat. And of course, with some means and one thing and another, not to mention, foreign spies or something coming in. There was no immigration. By the end of the war, say 1946, immigration started. 1947 was really taking off. And they came over by the boatload. I mean, the immigration was huge. Not only in Boston, all across the states, Philadelphia, California, Baltimore, places like that. And what happened, what made Dudley Street was the fact that there were ballrooms there. Now, the immigrants that were coming out in 1947 or so were a little bit older by just a few years than people that came out in previous years. And that's simply because they wanted to come out, but they couldn't because of the war. So they had to wait that 4 or 5 years. So 17 and 18, they were 21, 22, whatever. And now they're coming out and they're going to live with aunts and uncles or relatives or something. And that's fine, but after a while they get homesick. And the word kind of spreads, look, you want to see somebody from home, go to the ballroom down the Dulles. There were 5 on one street. Maybe say 400 or 500 yards maximum, the length of Dudley Street, there were 5 ballrooms. And they were all packed to the rafters. There was the Dudley Street Opera House. There was Winslow Hall. There was Hibernian. There was Intercolonial. And then the other one was Rolls Roy, which was kind of a Canadian Cape Breton thing, but with a lot of Irish music in there as well. And a lot of the Irish music was there. The music was terrific. So on a Saturday night, you'd have 3,000 or 4,000 people up and down Dudley Street every Saturday night, rain or shine. And it was just absolutely enormous. It was a fantastic thing. And every ballroom had its own band, and each band had its own little format of how you play the dance and which sequence you. And that's something that developed over a couple of years. Joey Powell had a band in London. That's the band I was with. My brother George worked with Joaquin Flaherty over in across the street there. Doesn't make any difference. But this is what it was. Joey Powell would say, look, we're going to do everything for free. He would play a waltz, and stop, play another waltz, stop, play another waltz, 3. You do hand playing, you do third. You do 3 medleys of polkas. And this is the format that he used. And that came about because of feedback things that you would get back. So out of all of this, you developed a kind of a pattern that just suited these people. And after a while, all the action art or young Italian fellows or whatever, Polish, whatever, they saw all these pretty girls going into this ball room every Saturday night. So they come by now and they start to investigate. And after a while, I mean, it's just, now what's going to happen? The weddings. And guess who got all the weddings? We did. And it was for, we did Thursday nights at the ball. Almost every Friday night we would do a bowling banquet or a wedding. Weddings were very popular on Friday nights. Saturday, you would do probably two weddings, certainly one every Saturday, not two, and go right from there to the ball. And Sunday, you were good for one wedding at least. And this went on week in and week out and week up. And Monday, you get up and go to work. But, so this was a very, very important part of my income. And it was great. And we had a ball down there. And you said some of the things that happened would have been knocked your socks off. But there's a little story there. Earle talked about it earlier, about Peter King's dream. It's a real life, but way, way back in the 40s. And the original Irish Hour in Boston, I used to play there live every Sunday night. And piano player, Johnny Connors, usually was around and liked to play. I liked to play with him too. Very good, and he was a friend of my teacher. That's how I met him. Well, Johnny was a bird, he was a free spirit. And that was the right way of saying it. He liked to do his own thing. And his idea of a perfect life would be to drink beer and play piano. Play Irish music. And he was very good at it. And he did all these 78s that I did in the 40s. But Johnny, you know, people would say, Johnny, we got to play next Sunday night. Oh, we got to dance, or we got to party. Would you play for us? I got sure. What time? Where are you? And of course, that's it. You have another couple of beers. And tomorrow, I get all So next Sunday night, we're over in the studio. And one of our announcers was Fred Kinsey. Of Boston Bruins fame. That's the same announcer who announced the Bruins game. And that's what he always wanted to do, even back there. Another one of our announcers was Bill Hamilton, who did all the political news of Boston for years. But any event, like Bill Hamilton would say, well, you're going to play night show? Yep. What are you going to do? Well, I'm going to do this field, that one fight, or whatever. And he'd say, it's accompanied by Johnny Connors. And Connors would say, you can't say that, don't say that. You have to make up a name. Don't say, let me make up a name. What's going on? He said, I'm supposed to be over in Deutschland, over in West Rochester, playing with songs. And if you say tonight that, you know, accompanied by Johnny Connors, I'm in trouble, you know. So, Bill would say, well, what are we going to do? Well, what name are we going to use? Johnny would say, I don't know. How about Peter Feeney? So when I wrote this reel, it was just kind of tongue-in-cheek. Peter Feeney's dream. Drink beer and play you. it was funny because for 6 months or so after that, some of the other musicians would call me, how do I get a hold of this Peter Feeney? And I'd say, well, what? Well, we like him, and you know, I'd like to get him. He's much more reliable. big difference to public health and music between entertainment and the old band.